The Spinier Federalism. This is the chapter 2 of the class 10th. In the earlier chapter, we have seen the importance of the power sharing. In the power sharing, with the examples of Sri Lanka and Belgium, we have studied the importance of power sharing. Now we will move the next part to look what is meant by the democracy and how it runs. These all chapters are part of democracy. Since last year, with the part first of the political science, we are studying only about the democracy. This is all are the features of democracy. So the federalism. While studying the power sharing, we have studied different forms of the power sharing. In that different forms of power sharing, one important form we have seen, the vertical distribution of the power. May you remember, recall the last chapters what we have studied. One point was there, the vertical distribution of the power sharing, central government, state government and local government. In this way, in India, the power is shared. Like this we have studied in the earlier chapter. So the federalism means the vertical distribution of the power. This is very easy to understand. Just connect the knowledge with the earlier knowledge, so you will move very easily to the next part. India's map, the states in the India. This is the newly map of the India. In this chapter, main points what we are going to study, the important points are here. We are going to study in this chapter what is federalism, the meaning of federalism you will understand very well. Then features of Indian federalism. Why Indian government or the Indian system can be called federalism. That is why the features of Indian federalism we will see. Then federalism in a practice, types of federation and decentralization. These all points in detail, one by one, we are going to study in this chapter. Features of Indian, features of federalism. What is the federalism? Important characteristics of the federalism. The federalism means in which government there are two or more levels of government, that kind of government is called federal government or federal system. This is having two or more levels of government. This is the point you will look. The first point, two or more levels of the government. Second, the second feature of federalism is each level has its own power or jurisdiction. Jurisdiction means control area. Every level of the government is having its controlling area. Jurisdiction is specified by the constitution. Constitution given guarantee, or it is specified by the constitution what is the jurisdiction of the state government or the central government. And there is a constitutional guarantee of authority. This authority is given by the constitution, or this is the constitutional guarantee. Constitutional provisions can be changed only with the consent of both level of government. If some changes are needing to make in the constitutional provisions, one government cannot make it. For that, we need Wait 2 minutes. Constitutional provisions can be changed only with the consent of both levels of government. One government cannot make any change in the constitutional. When it is needing to make any change in the constitution, the both governments, the state government and the central government, both consents are needing. In both level, majority is needing in both houses. Next, court interprets the constitution and powers of different levels of government. The constitutional articles are interpreted by the court. The Supreme Court is guardian of constitution. Whatever meaning given by the court, that will be the final. No other level of government will interpret, or any other body will interpret the meaning of constitution on their own themselves. The court is the final who interprets the constitution in the way of the articles or the legal way. Supreme Court is the umpire if dispute arises with different levels of government. If there are disputes among the both governments, means state government and the central government, that time this Supreme Court is having final decision or working as an umpire. Umpire, you know, while watching cricket or any other matches, you very familiar with this word. So the court is working here as an umpire. Supreme Court is the umpire if disputes arise with different levels of government. The sources of revenues are clearly specified. Both kind of governments are needing revenue collection. So what are the sources for central government or what are the sources for the state government? This is clearly specified through the constitution. And if this revenue is collected to the central government, what percentage should be given to the state government? That is also clearly said. So there should be no any matter or any dispute among the both kind of governments. These are the features of the federalism. Wherever, in which country these are followed, in that country we can say the federalism is followed. So in this way we can define the federalism. It is a system of government in which power is divided between a central authority and various constituent units of the country. The power is not centralized in one unit. The power is decentralized or distributed or divided in the different levels of the government. The federalism means having more than two levels of the government. It means there are more than two levels of the government. Power is not centralized in one hand. The unitary government. unitary government means what we will see here. There are two types of government. Federalism already we have seen. Now we will look here the unitary. In the unitary government, with the name you can understand, only one level of government is there in unitary government. There are no different levels of government, no power sharing. The power is centralized at one level. That kind of government is called unitary government. Then subunits. The subunits may are having there, but they are subordinated to the central government or the to one government. Because one only government, so no use to call it central government or the state government. Maybe the units are there, but they are completely subordinate to the upper level government. Center can pass orders to the local government. Center can pass any order to the local government. The example is given here, the United Kingdom. United Kingdom is following unitary kind of government. I hope you people are understand the federalism and unitary. In a federalism, there are two or more levels of government. In unitary government, only one level of government. In a federalism, there are different authorities given to the state as well as center. But in a unitary, the subunits are completely subordinated to the one kind of government. In the federalism, the center cannot pass all orders to the local government. But in unitary government, the state government or the subunit have to work in the way what the government is said. For the federalism, we can take the example. The best example is the India. Objectives of the federalism. Why should we follow the federalism? Because in the first chapter, we have studied the importance of power sharing. So the objective of federalism, very easily you will get to safeguard, promote the unity of the country. It is the way to keep the unity safe and to promote. The India is the best example. Because of the federalism, the country is having unitedly together. And the second objective is here to accommodate regional diversity. When different levels are there, state government is there, that time it respects the regional diversity. Maharashtra is having different their own culture. Karnataka is having their own culture. Assam is having their own culture. So that regional diversities are respected through the federalism. These are the main two objectives of the federalism. Two crucial aspects of an ideal federalism. When the federalism will get success, when these two things will be followed properly, that time only the federalism will be get success. What should needing there? Just having authority is not enough for the both government. Governments at different levels should agree to some rules of power sharing. Mutual understanding is needing here. The state government and the central government. When work mutual with the mutual understanding, that time federalism will get success. It is happening in India. When center and state government are showing their mutual understanding, that time the federalism will get success. Next, trust and agreement to live together must be there. The trust is working importantly here. If mistrust are there among them, it is not working successfully. To get success, the trust of central government to the state government and state government on the central government on each other, trust is needing. Then only the federalism will get success. Today we have look about the what is meaning of federalism, the features of federalism, the need of federalism, and when it will be get success. these four points we have studied in the first point, that what is the federalism. Okay, what has made India a federal country? How can we say that India is a federal country or not unitary government? Go toward the earlier part, the features of federalism. Look, the first point of that features of federalism is the government are having more than two levels. In India, you know, there are three levels of government: central government, state government, and local government. So this one feature is applied here. All the features, what seven features are there, all that seven features are applying to the India. That is why we can say India is a federal country. Constitution has declared India as a union states. Initially, Constitution is declared, it is the union of the states. The states are here and it is the union of that all states. Different levels. Three tiers of government. Three tiers federalism. Three tiers are having here. Union government, state government, and panchayat, the local governments. Threefold distribution of legislative powers under union list, state list, and concurrent list. Right, somewhere we have referred about it. Maybe in a class 9th somewhere, and in a class 8 also. I don't know whether you remember or not, but again, this part is repeating here. Three lists are given there for which government, which work is given. One is union list, second is state list, and third is concurrent list. In union list, it includes the subject of the national importance. The union list works to the complete nation. Like defense, the defense is a matter of the complete nation. So that subject falls in the union list. National importance such as defense of the country, foreign affairs, banking, communication, and currency. Like these subjects are involved in the union list. Listen carefully, read carefully. The slide also you have to read, and afterward read the textbook to understand it. They are included in this list because we need a uniform policy on these matters. Because these subjects are needing a uniform policy. In a defense matter, the different policies we cannot take from the different states. The decision should be taken by one hand. That is why this is involved in the union list. The second is state list. Whatever state matters are there, the regional diversity involves here, the regional problems are involved here, that all subjects are involved in the state list. For example, police, trade, commerce, agriculture, and irrigation. These subjects are involved in the state list. The state can make the law themselves in this matter. The state and panchayat are part of same. Next is the concurrent list. Some subjects are there where which cannot give to the one level, to the central government or to the state government. The both governments contribution is a needing in some subject. That subjects involves in the concurrent list. These three lists are important in the study. Mostly the question is asked for 3 marks on these three lists. So you have to look carefully on these three lists, understand the three lists. It is very easy. Union list, central government, state list, state government, and concurrent list, both works together. The concurrent list, we will see, it includes the subject of common interest of both the union government as well as the state government. The subjects are education, forest, trade, trade unions, marriage, adoption, and succession. Both the union as well as the state government can make laws on the subjects mentioned in this list. If their laws conflict with each other, the laws made by the union government will prevail. If the state government and union government both can make laws about the subject of the concurrent list. If conflicts arise about that laws, that time the laws which are made by the union government get final. Next, we'll see. Listen carefully, my dear students. All states in the Indian Union do not have identical powers. The 28 states are not having same power. There are differences. Last year, we have seen about the cancellation of 370 article. Before that, the 370 article was giving a special treatment to the Jammu and Kashmir. What was the special treatment? Any Indian citizen cannot buy land in the Jammu and Kashmir. That was the provision according to 370. It was there, now it is cancelled. May in your book it is mentioned or may not, because some prints are old, some are new. In new it is involved or not, don't know. The laws or the rules which were made by the central were, it was not compulsory to accept the Jammu and Kashmir government. The Jammu and Kashmir assembly was passing the laws, then whether to adopt this law or not, they were passing the bill and then adopting or not. So this special treatment was there. Again, one thing is here, it is not only about the Jammu and Kashmir. The Jammu and Kashmir was having was where it was there the special treatment, but now it is not there. Some eastern states are having special treatment because the geographical difficulties are there. Due to these geographical difficulties, the states need special treatment. So some special favors are given to the eastern states. Another part is again having in the Indian federalism, some parts are very small. These are some units of the Indian Union which enjoy very little power. They are having very little power because in a size also they are small. These are areas which are too small to become an independent state. We cannot recognize them as an independent state because they are very small, but which could not be merged with any of the existing state. We cannot merge also. Means it remain separate. This part remaining going to separate. I hope you are understanding what I am talking here. It is about the union territories. These parts are the union territories. It are ruled by the union government. The union territories, these are these areas like Chandigarh or Lakshadweep or the capital city of Delhi. These are called union territories. These territories do not have the powers of a state. This territory is not having power as a state. They are very small in a size. The central government has a special powers in running these areas. These areas are ruled by the central government. Here is the two ways of the federalism. You will get two types of federalism. One is coming together and second is holding together. In coming together, independent states coming together on their own to form bigger unit. The America is an example here. These states are independent. They are not controlled by other, but for some purpose, to complete some need, these units come together and form a bigger unit. This is coming together unit or the federalism. Why they are coming together? They come together to increase security. By remaining with each other, they want to increase the security. Increase security by pooling sovereignty and retaining identity. The sovereignty also remains separately and identity also remains separate along with more security. This is the main motive, objective for the coming together federalism. In this kind of federalism, all constituents are having equal power. The all units we have seen in the earlier part, in India, all states are not having same power. Some states are treated specially. They are having special powers. But in coming together, the all states, all units are having equal power. The examples are given here. USA, Switzerland, Australia, these countries are followed the coming together federalism. The next is here, holding together federalism. Coming together, they come together themselves by willingly. In holding together, the main vast unit is, and this unit is divided in subparts. By understanding the title, you will understand the matter also. First, understand the title, coming together, they come willingly together. But in holding together, the one land is already having, the region, the unit is a vast, but it divided in a different parts, like India. India is a vast country, union country. Afterward, the states are made. In class 8, you have studied it. Recall that, then you will understand easily this also. The large country decides to divide power between constitutional units and centers. The different states are made of the large country. This is the holding together. Center is more powerful vis-a-vis the state. Both are powerful here. Constituents, units of federation have unequal powers. Already it is explained by the giving examples of the northeastern states and the Jammu and Kashmir. The examples are India, Spain, and Belgium. These are the examples of the both kind of federalism, coming together and holding together. I hope till here you have understand the all part. Both points read again. After half an hour, again, I will start the next session.